starting to repot my bonsai. I just had to get rid of some soil. So let me show you here. Thanks for watching. I am ASMR Artists from ASMR Artists. And here you can see I am currently bathing my bonsai. Did you ever bathe your bonsai? So, just moving it around in the water a little bit. Getting the water to, we'll hold it like this. That way, first I get more water in one place, get it higher, and you get to hopefully see it better. Bathing my bonsai, bathing my bonsai. I'm just bathing my bonsai. Now, I'm gonna take the little chopstick. This helps because the water is just much more gentle and more easy to wash off the soil. And I'm just gonna get in the nooks and crannies and help the water a little bit, trying not to break the branches, of course. This is the biggest clear container I had. I was hoping you could see more of what I was doing. This one. You hear it scratching, but this is wood, so maybe it's bamboo, but it looks like wood, so it's not gonna damage it really. Just gonna take off any stuff we don't want. There we go. Bathing my bonsai, bathing my bonsai. I want to be bathing my bonsai. I'm not going to take off all the hair roots because, of course, they're really good at taking up nutrients. So, Betty Bonsai might need it. Her name's Betty. I just decided just now. You're here with the birth of the name. Didn't have a name for her yet. But Betty Bonsai seems right, don't you think? Okay, there we go. So we have the main big roots right here. These big. And then here are smaller roots. This one has to come off. This doesn't work. Here are the smaller ones with the root hairs. And you can see they're bright yellow, whitish color. So that means they're healthy and active. So this one also. So we're going to keep those, and gave her a little bath, take off all the excess soil, and now we're going to put her in her new place, her new pot. I don't really feel I have to trim roots, since most of it came off pretty easily, and I don't really see, I'm not sure about this thing. Do you see that? Sticking up, but I'm thinking it might become a new plant. So I don't think I should take her off. I want to see how she would be in the pot if I need to take a part of this guy off, just because it's really long and it might be why she was toppling over like this. Because I really don't want her to do that. I want her to be straight up. So Betty's gonna maybe lose part of one of the big roots, but she will have a lot of other stuff working with her. Ficus really love water, so this should be a joy for her. Nice bath. Nice water bath. Clean her off. No more dust. No more old stuff. New fresh start. Okay. Drain Betty Bonsai well. Like a baby. Oh no, I lost a lot of viewers with going offline. It's too bad. I didn't purposely do that. But an alarm I should have changed today, so sorry. I'm offline. Let's see how she's gonna fit into her new pot. These wires have to go down here. I can wire a little bit better now around the roots to keep them steady. There we go. So the wiring is done to make the branches go in the direction you want them to. So if I put her up straight, she's going to be like this. And then indeed, I'm feeling this guy is a little too long. It's probably what pushed her over to the side. So I'm going to take that off. I'm going to take part of this root off. Probably around here, where the rest also is probably going to be really tough. I'm sorry, Betty Bonsai. So this is what I took off. Little foot. Oh no, looks like a little foot. I'm so sorry, Betty. I'm sure you're going to be okay, sweetheart. I'm sorry. But then she will fit nicely in there like this. Part of this, do I want to take it off? Just a little bit, but no, I think she's going to be okay like this. Yeah, this looks good, right? Looks like a better, more straight bonsai. Okay, so now that I'm happy with my pot and what she's going to look like, I'm going to safely put her down. I'll put her in the bath just because she likes it like that. And hopefully she will stay. I want to cover the holes in here because murky water. Because I don't want the soil getting out of here, right? So what I do usually is I have these, like these nets. These were from onions. This is Dutch, but it says onion. And your onions come in these, right? And then what you do, you use them and then you throw them out. But if I just cut off these metal parts, because they might rust and we don't need them there, just cut these off. I really like recycling and reusing stuff. And these are little nets, which I think we get a lot of, which we don't really use after we get the onions out. So I just spread it out like this, and I put it in the bottom, and then you can see that's perfect for keeping my soil in here, not out there. So it's wonderful, easy way to recycle. I'm going to wait to put it back in here. So what's next? And then she puts it back. I have here a bowl. In this bowl, I hope you can see that. Filling. I have sand. This is chinchilla sand. I needed it for my lithops, which are amazing, weird, alien little succulent plants. And this too, little stones. It also has some tiny pieces of shell in there. And these I'm going to put in my soil mix together with the coconut. So that makes it a really well-draining soil mix. You can add regular soil to the mix as well, but I don't feel I need to, and I think this is going to be a really good mix. So I will add the coconut. I think it's probably going to be, I have to guesstimate, I think it's 1/5 sand or sand-like soil, 2/5 maybe is stones. No, like 1/6 and 2/6, 1/6, and then 3/6 is coconut. And then I'll have to see if I can fit that all in. Or maybe I will need more. Okay. Clean my hands for a second. I do have a little cloth to dry. And then I'm going to take this wooden spoon to mix my soil mix. So, I've mixed in my soil mix. Now I'm going to take back my beautiful Japanese plate. It's just sometimes nice to buy things that you really like the look of, just because it makes you a little bit happy to work with them. I take my little pot, the insert, and I'm going to place one layer of soil first, also just to cover the net, to make a base for my Betty Bonsai that she can sit on. She will enjoy. I did like how she stuck out of the soil. I don't want her too deep, so I'm not going to put a big layer, but if you want your bonsai to stick up higher, just put in more. Okay, there we go. So I want her to be in there like this. So I have to hold her now and then add soil in the pot. And so it's going to go in between the roots. And I'm going to use my chopstick to really push it in the middle and in between everything. Because we don't want any gaps. We do want it to be very draining and to let it drain the water down easily through the whole pot, but we don't want to have air gaps in there. We really want all the roots to get all of this yummy, delicious nutrients that are in the soil. It's a challenge with the Retusa, Ficus Retusa Ginseng, because it can really have strange gaps and openings in that huge root structure that they have. And if I don't have enough for the whole bowl to really be full, I don't mind so much because I can always add more of my coconut soil to the top. And it will look nicer than this mixture with sand and stones. It's not really beautiful, right? So, that's fine. As long as most of the roots have this soil mixture on it. I think she's now stable. Look, I can let go of her. She's steady in the bowl, which makes me really happy because she's finally up straight. Wouldn't you be happy if you could finally stand up straight after being crooked for probably 3 years? I really hope I'm making Betty Bonsai happy again. I know I'm making me happy. That also counts for something. And I know that if I'm happy, my plants will be more happy. So it might be a win-win, but it's a good thing in any case. I know that taking care of plants just makes me happy because I'm doing something nice for a living creature, I guess. It's not really a being, but to me they're creatures. I think I can make a topping. And that's just nice to do something positive for something else. Well, this is Betty. She's someone. Because you're doing something, I guess, something sweet. Something is going to enjoy. Okay, there we go. I'm going to be adding this as a topping. But first, I have to go use my chopstick. Where's my chopstick? Where'd you go? Here you go. To really put soil in and around all the roots and kind of push it down a little bit. And you will see. Look, there's not really a lot of room, but when I push it down, it's compacting and it's really sinking in, I can tell you. I will need a good topping. But I don't mind. It'll look good. And she will be in here much more secure. I do want it to be airy, so I don't want to push it down too much. I don't want to like stuff it in there. Just move it a little bit to create some more space for more soil and to make sure that there's no air pockets and there's soil around all of the roots so she can get her nutrients easily. There we go. I do like the little peekaboo that I can see through it. You see that? I don't want to put too much soil in there. I enjoy that little gap. So, yeah. I need a lot more here. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is just add little bits of the coconut into here. Thank you for following. Hey, sweetheart. How are you doing? Just going to put some all around and then push it in a little bit. There we go. Nice and gently. Do something nice for my Betty Bonsai. I'm sorry your previous owners didn't really want to put in the care, but I'm happy they let me know. They said their house was also not really suitable for the bonsai because she needs a lot more sun, so that's too bad. I hope they don't miss her. I've sent them pictures of her later. I know that's a little bit nuts, but I am. Go, Betty. Get all this soil. Some nice nutrients for you. There we go. It's always nice to have a little hill leading towards your bonsai. You don't need it to be, but I guess it's traditional. And it looks nice. Although here with the gaps, I'm not sure what to do because I enjoy the gaps. So I'll just put some soil right next to it. I'm trying to find a stream on your wavelength, and this seems perfect. I'm happy to hear that. I'm glad, sweetheart. I hope it works out that way. Can you tell me about your wavelength? Well, can you tell me about your wavelength? What you enjoy watching? Adding soil to bed. I like to think that there's room here for like a little leprechaun or elves or something who can go in there and have a nap. I remember when I was a kid, we would bike past this one park, and my mom and I think my dad too, would stop sometimes, go look for leprechauns. And this one time, we found, in the hole of the trunk of a tree, we found this tiny little hat of a leprechaun. So I was sure, after that, that they existed, and that they lived in that tree. It's a very special tree. I have to do that for my daughter sometime. She's 5 now, so. Oh, I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna make a little leprechaun hat. soon, and then on a holiday we're gonna put it in there in a tree somewhere. It's gonna be so much fun. Okay, I think she's good like this. You can still see the gap. Can you see through there? Oh, I can see you. Can you see me? Okay, maybe like this. My finger in there, yeah. And in here. That's so cool. And even here, there's a little hole, but you don't see it from where you are. So she looks really good now. I'm gonna do one last thing before I put her in there, back in her pot, and say that she's finished. Oh, yes. Careful, delicate work, done with care and tenderness. Those are wonderful words as well. Yes, I agree. I really enjoy that too. It's a part of the Japanese culture I really enjoy, how they are very mindful about everything they do and very careful. And yeah, I guess delicate. Bet you like bonsai as well. So do I, obviously. So what I gotta do now, one last step, I get to water Betty. I get to give her a drink. So I'll just switch some stuff around here. We give her a good drink before she's finished and goes back in her pot. Didn't take too long. I wasn't sure how long this would take. Oh yeah, you do? I've visited Japan a couple of times. That's when I fell in love with it first time. I was 10. It's a really, really amazing place. I have a couple of videos I did in Japan, and a lot of videos Japanese items like candy and books and stuff. Most are on my YouTube, but I have some here on Twitch as well. But definitely, once this whole weirdness blows over, go to Japan. It's amazing. It's not expensive as expensive as most people think. You can definitely budget travel there. And it's a really amazing place. Highly recommend it. And get a bonsai when you're there. Oh, I hope she's gonna stay in her pot. I'm gonna do it like this because I'm scared she's gonna have to hold the pot. Okay, there we go. I'm gonna water her until it runs through the bottom. Her leaves also like a little spray. There we go. There you go, Betty. Because a lot of the soil was not moist. And especially ficus ginseng really love water. Get in the hole there. Whoa! It's taking up a lot of water. See? It's hardly any getting out yet. Maybe I should turn this open a little bit more. Oh, did you see that? Okay, that didn't work well. Oh no, go this way. It came out the wrong way. Definitely go with your friends. It is very, very respectful and considerate and polite, except for with the animals. Yeah, oh, you're from Australia, that's nice. Yeah, I'm not sure if you can check the rules. Yeah, Australia, I remember, is very specific, especially about fruits and plants, etc., which is smart. There we go. Not seeping through. Okay, I'm making a little bit of a mess, but I'm cleaning her. So I'm happy about that. I'm taking a shower myself. There we go. Okie dokie. So happy. Look, she's back up straight. And it's running out the bottom, which is what we need. I already cleaned this baby. And now we get to put Betty back where she belongs. Whoa, focus. Exactly. Well, a lot of what's in Australia has been imported, of course, but it can be so dangerous for the native plants and flora and fauna. Which would be a pity. Let me take this out of the way. I just bought a new Monstera Deliciosa. This one. It has a pot very similar to one, so it looks like a big sister. Look, so cute. And here's baby Betty. Baby Betty Bonsai. These are the branches that I cut off to trim it so that she would have a nice shape. I'm going to change the shape a little bit further if I can. And I put them together, bound them really tightly, and then they're going to grow into each other. They're going to grow together into a new bonsai with one big trunk. So it's pretty cool with the wiring that I did. I can make these branches more in the shape that I like. So I'm really happy that my Betty Bonsai is now standing up straight, standing straight and tall and proud, like she should be. New Zealand and a senior. Flightless bird with no predators. Oh no. Well, then the Europeans showed up, so they probably ate them, right? That helps. Yeah, she is looking much happier. So here's my Betty Bonsai. Really happy again. I'm happy again. She looks fresh and happy in her new pot. I hope this is relaxing and or educational for you. I think it took me about an hour to do, so it's very manageable and it will make your plants happy. I can do some wiring videos later someday, but yeah, I hope this was nice for you. So, sweet dreams, or have an amazing day. Thank you for watching my channel. Check out all my other channels if you want. I have a Patreon with exclusive content, private messaging. I have a YouTube with body sounds, and I have a Twitch with all kinds of other weird ASMR, because I like to do weird ASMR.